Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. As they were coming down from the mountain, the disciples asked Jesus, "Why do the scribes say that Elijah must come first?" Jesus said in reply, "Elijah will indeed come and restore all things. But I tell you that Elijah has already come." And they did not recognize him, but did to him whatever they pleased. So also will the Son of Man suffer at their hands. Then the disciples understood that he was speaking to them of John the Baptist. The Gospel of the Lord. Well, Advent is rather short this year. It's just one day beyond 3 weeks. And right now, we are standing at the point where the final preparations for Christmas are beginning. Tomorrow, December 17th, will be the third Sunday of Advent. The following week will be the fourth Sunday of Advent, and the next day is Christmas Day. Beginning on the 17th, for the ordinary weekdays, there's a special set of masses that focus very, very clearly on the immediate preparation for Jesus' coming. It's sort of like we're getting into a landing pattern in our final stage of preparation for Christmas. And today, we focus on Elijah the prophet. Elijah was seen as the greatest, the epitome of the prophets of the Old Testament. He is the one who appeared to Jesus and the apostles, along with Moses and Elijah at the Transfiguration. This gospel reading that we just heard took place as Jesus and the small number of disciples were coming down from the Mount of Transfiguration. That's the mountain that they were coming down from as at the very beginning of this reading. They had just experienced this vision of Jesus with Moses and Elijah. And Moses and Elijah were pointing to Jesus as the one whose coming they had anticipated. They were part of the preparation for the coming of Jesus. There was a popular sentiment among the Jewish people of Jesus' time that Elijah is recorded in the Old Testament as not having died. He was taken up to heaven alive in a fiery chariot. So the expectation was he is going to come again. He is the one who will come and restore Israel to its place of glory among the nations. That was the expectation. So the disciples asked him about that. Why did they say that Elijah must come first? And Jesus said, well, he has come. Not in the way of bringing with him the fullness of the kingdom of God, but rather the one who is the kind of the last moment of preparation for the coming of that kingdom, which we now know and understood comes in Jesus Christ. And so Elijah is a fitting one to kind of launch us onto this final week of consideration of preparation for the coming of Jesus. He is the one who, with John the Baptist, sums up the entirety of the Old Testament, sums up everything that God has revealed in order to prepare for the coming of Jesus. So this week, let's really ask the Lord to enter our hearts, to make room for understanding who and what Jesus is as he comes into our lives.